is an acclaimed band
known for helping popularize the Notte Dolce Hertha movement,
a subgenre of rock music that developed throughout Germany and Austria in the early 90s. Formed in Berlin in 1994, Rammstein was quickly picked up by Mortar Music, releasing their debut album, Herzeleid, the following year. Even though Herzeleid initially sold poorly, the band managed to continue gaining popularity and eventually released their second album, Seinsucht, which hit number one on the charts in their home country of Germany and also spawned the notable song Engel, as well as the worldwide smash Du Hast, which gained them international popularity and the muscle to be picked up by major label Universal Music. Their third album, Mutter, was released to equal praise. It's this album's lead-off single, Sonne, that contains our mystery. According to Rammstein's lead vocalist and lyricist, Till Lindemann, Sonne was originally titled Klitschko, as it had been originally written as an entrance song for the boxer-turned-politician Vitali Klitschko. However, keyboardist Christian Lorenz said it was written for Vitali's brother, Vladimir, also a professional boxer. Regardless of which Klitschko brother Sonne was written for, the one thing that stays consistent is that Rammstein wrote it in the year 2000 upon request. Rounding back to 1995, the year Rammstein released Herzeleid, they played a concert on December 15th in Bad Lobenstein. The handwritten setlist from the show still exists, and on it is a song called Sonne, something that has baffled Rammstein fans. With no known bootleg of the show having surfaced, we can only speculate what this song was. Some theorize that it's actually an early version of the song of the same name released on Mutter, since it's not uncommon for bands to shelve songs that are a work in progress, only to record and release them several years later after the band feels that the song is properly finalized. However, if this were the case here, then that would completely contradict several statements made that the Sonne that appeared on their third album was written in the year 2000 for one of the Klitschko brothers. As such, it's commonly accepted that these two are completely different songs, leading to the mysterious tune on the set list to be labeled
Sonne 1995 or
Sonne 95. Other theories suggested throughout the years is that Sonne 95 was just the alternate title of another song. This is supported by the fact that other songs written on this particular set list use their working titles instead of the titles on their official releases, because the band was still used to recognizing a lot of these songs by their working titles. This practice of writing alternate song titles on set lists isn't uncommon even outside of Rammstein. So this theory holds water, and since there's enough evidence to support that Sonne 95 could just be an alternate title to one of their other songs, then the question remains, which song is it? All in all, the three possibilities are that Sonne 95 is 1. An early version of the hit that would eventually be released on Mutter, 2. An unreleased Rammstein song that has yet to surface, or 3. A released Rammstein song under an alternate title. And if so, which song is it, and why did they change the title? If I had to guess, I keep falling back on number 1, based on the fact that bands shelf songs all the time and don't release a recording until years later, and a lot of the times they sound completely different. I understand that Rammstein confirmed that Sonne was written in the year 2000 at the request of one of the Klitschko brothers, yet whether it was Vladimir or Vitali isn't even consistent. I'm not saying anyone's lying, but I'm suggesting that minor misremembering and slight shifts in perspectives between those involved have possibly made this into an unwitting conspiracy. Paul Landers has confirmed that Sonne was originally intended to be an instrumental.
Well, the song is about two brothers who are both boxers. They're called the Klitschko brothers and they come from the Ukraine. They were on their way to becoming world champions, but unfortunately, one of them had really awful music to step into the ring to. Somehow, we found out from their management that this guy was interested in finding a new entrance tune. So every time we went to our rehearsal room, we tried to move in a way that a boxer would move to get the tempo just right. We felt that he needed a really epic piece of music, and originally we planned it as a purely instrumental track, something to make the most of his walk out to the fight.
considering that Sonne, or Sun in English, is a relatively generic title? What if Sonne 95 was an instrumental jam the band came up with on a whim sometime in 1995, played it once, shelved it, and when one of the Klitschko brothers requested the band write a song for them, they dusted off this instrumental jam, heavily repurposed it to fit a boxing theme, and simply kept the generic title. Maybe the end result of Sonne is so completely different to what they began with Sonne 95, that the band doesn't even associate the two, which is why they've always referred to Sonne's creation as happening in the year 2000. Bands have instrumental jams all the time, which not only helps them warm up for performances, but also guides them in exchanging ideas for new songs. It's very possible that because Rammstein does this so regularly, they wouldn't even associate Sonne 95 and Sonne. All that's really left is to ask them. The Sonne 95 mystery is on a list of questions that fans have created to ask the band next time they wish to do a Q&A session. Until then, there's not much else to do other than continue to theorize or hope that a bootleg of the December 15th, 1995 show surfaces.